Hello students, let's today talk about the first chapter of 12th class, Reproduction in Organisms. Now, what is reproduction? Reproduction is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones. The young ones are offsprings and which are generally similar to itself. Generally in the sense because they have variations. And what is the significance of reproduction? That it enables continuity of a species. And why we need to continue species? Because every organism has a lifespan. So wherever I'm saying this because, that is what you will be needing for your assertion and reasoning type of questions. Now let us see what is a lifespan. Now the period from the birth to natural death of an organism is called lifespan. So lifespan is the time period of the organism, the birth se lekar uske death tak. Let's see some examples. What are the lifespans of various organisms? For example, this, as I've written, elephant has 50 to 60 years, rose 5 to 10 years, and as the different organisms have different lifespan. So, sabse kam lifespan dekho yahan maine likhi hai ek mayfly ki. Mayfly ki, the adult survives only for a day. And maybe maximum lifespan is maybe of this a tortoise, which is 150 years. Now, on what this lifespan depends? Do you think this depends on? Will this depend on? Will it depend on size of the organism? Do you think this depends on life of organism? Let's see. Suppose yahan pe ek example hum dekhte hain, jaise ki crow ka aur parrot ka. Both are birds and of the same size. But see the difference in the lifespan. Crow can survive only for 15 years, whereas the parrot for 140 years. So no. So this is a big no. It does not depend on the size of organisms. So, but there are certain organisms, like we can say the single-celled organisms. These organisms, they have no natural death because they give birth to their daughter cells. So we can say that they are immortal and because they do not have a natural death. Now only for PMT, let us see, this is not for the boards. So wherever I'll put this bracket, this is only for PMT. Now some organisms, why do the organisms, they age and die? So this is a big question, like there are various theories of aging and related things. Now study of aging is called gerontology. So there are various theories. Like the first most accepted theory is called the telomerase theory, and in which the telomerase enzyme will be synthesizing the tails of a chromosome. What are the tails of a chromosome? Suppose you have seen the structure of a chromosome. The chromosome has a tail, and this resembles the ends of a shoelace. So there is a plastic covering at the end of every shoelace, and this is how the telomeres resemble. Now suppose this shoelace ka jo ye end hai, ye plastic ka cover, agar ye kharab ho jaye, so this will be spoiling your shoelace. Similarly, chromosome also has a tail, and this tail is always made up of, this is rich in guanosine and nucleotides. And it is single stranded, GGGGG, इसमें होते हैं बहुत सारे. Now, जितनी बार ये chromosome duplicate होता है, replicate होता है, उतनी बार ये tail shorten होने लगती है, छोटी होने लगती है. And this is what we say is the telomere theory. So now this shortening of this tail is was given by this scientist Hayflick, and we call it as a Hayflick limit, that every chromosome or every cell has a limited, restricted limit to which it can reproduce, multiply. And there was a Nobel Prize 2009 given to Blackburn, Carroll and Schotzek for this telomere study. Let's see the other theory. So there is a free radical theory or the DNA damage theory. Now because of metabolic reactions, there tend to be wear and tear in the cell. And this leads to accumulation of oxidative compounds which damage the cell biomolecules. And this leads to the death of the cell. Now, बहुत सारे ऐसे reactions होते रहते हैं cell के अंदर, जिससे कुछ oxidative reactions होने के कारण there will be some damaging of the proteins and the carbohydrates and lipid molecules, and that may damage the cell structure, and this cell structure will be leading to the death of the cell. Now cell death is called apoptosis wherever it is happening. And then there is a programming in genome theory. Now according to this, we have programmed death. That means that it is already there in your genome, and we will be going to die in within that time period. Now let's see on what factors reproduction of an organism depends upon. Now it depends on the habitat, environment, and internal physiology. Now let us see factor habitat. Now habitat and environment means if the conditions are favorable, organism will reproduce. Ek bahut acha example is mein giant panda ka. Giant panda is the one that you have seen, that teddy bear type of bear. Now this bear will be reproducing only when there will be bamboo plant flowering. Now because the population organism eat bamboo leaves, so it will be only reproducing when the bamboo plant will be in abundance. So when the plant will flower, so they get this indication of reproduction. Now this is why the population of giant panda is decreasing, because they have a restricted population in China, and if the bamboo jungles are cut, so there'll be lesser plants, and you know bamboo flowers only once in its lifetime, so their population is also very restricted. Now in internal physiology, this means that the chemical reactions happening within the organism. If the internal physiology means that the metabolism of the organism, and it is also a programmed thing, and the physiological reactions happening. Now the reproduction is again of two types. It could be sexual and asexual. Let's see what are the differences between the two. Asexual will occur in simpler organisms, as well as only a single parent is involved, whereas sexual will be occurring in mostly the complex organisms, and there'll be two individuals or sex organs involved. It has to be male and female. And in asexual, there'll be no gamete formation, gamete nahi banenge, or no gamete formation and no fertilization. Whereas in sexual, there'll be gamete forms and there'll be fertilization to restore the chromosome number. So because yahan pe na gamete bante hain na fertilization hogi, so it will be as such a new organism is formed from a single cell of a parent. So this will be, offsprings will be clones. But sexual mein there will be variations because of the meiosis involved and the fusion of gametes. So that are the differences between the two. Let's detail the asexual reproduction in various organisms. Now the first is, there are various types, like there could be budding in yeasts, there could be external internal buds in hydra and sponges, there could be binary fission in amoeba or bacteria, and multiple fission in plasmodium, and there could be spore formation in algae and fungi. Let's detail them now one by one. So let's start with the first one, budding in yeast, as in the book. Now you know yeast is a fungus. It has got a cell wall and it has a big vacuole and a nucleus. Now when the bud is formed, it will be just pinching off of a small part of that cell, and the thing is that this bud will be smaller in size always with that of the parental cell. So there is an unequal division in the budding of yeast. Mind this is very important, that there is an unequal pinching off, unequal cells form. Now this could be a question in your exam, school exam or your board exam, that how it is different from binary fission. So binary fission, jaise ki amoeba mein hoga, to wahan pe jab bhi do cell banenge, to hamesha these two cells will be, daughter cells will be always equal in size. But if I consider the budding, this way there will be an unequal division that will be occurring. The nucleus will divide, cytoplasm will be there in the other daughter cell also, bud also, but then there will be an unequal division. The bud may detach from the parental body, parental cell, or it may remain growing here. So this may form a structure like this, smaller, and there could be further budding occurring, but then they may detach or they may not. But there, suppose if we talk about the binary fission in amoeba, So the cell will be having a fissure developed, and this fissure will be pinching of the two cells into two equal daughter cells. So that's the biggest difference between budding and binary fission. Let's see how it occurs in Hydra, budding in Hydra. Now Hydra, you know, is a cylindrid. Now this organism, during favorable conditions, when asexual reproduction occurs, mind this, asexual reproduction generally hamesha hoga jab conditions are favorable, because they'll be reproducing very fast, so there has to be food and enough space. So there shouldn't be no environmental resistance for asexual reproduction. Now the bud form can be external like this, or it could be an internal bud, as in this is shown here, is in the sponges. This is called gemmule. And kaisa dikhta hai gemmule? Gemmule mein dekho, yahan pe kuch spicules hain ye. Spicules kya the? Spicules the skeletal system jo banate the sponges ka. They could be made up of calcium carbonate, it could be silica, or it could be the spongin fibers. And there are some, inside there will be some totipotent cells. What are totipotent cells? These are the cells which can de-differentiate and re-differentiate. So they have this capability of forming a new organism as a whole. Let us see how the spores, they are formed in algae and fungi. So this is an algae like Chlamydomonas. And it will be forming many zoospores. So these are called the zoospores. Zoo because they are motile. So motile spores are always called zoospores. Zoo means animal. So during the classification, Carl Linnaeus classified organisms which are motile into animal kingdom. So that is how the name comes, zoospores. And in case of fungus, like this is Penicillium. So there will be Stigmata, Metula, and there are conidiospores, or conidia we can say. So the spores, they are pinched off from a vertical hypha in a chain. So when they are pinched off in a chain, they are called the conidiospores. But suppose if they would have been pinched off singly, so I would have called it as a oidiospores or oidia. Let's see what happens in Plasmodium. So Plasmodium, you know, is a malaria causing parasite. So when it has to reproduce, it multiplies, it produces many sporozoids by multiple fission. So the cell will be breaking down into small cytoplasmic particles. And each will be, there will be one nucleus and surrounded by small amount of cytoplasm. So these structures, they are called sporozoids, which can further infect human being. And another situation is encystment and sporulation in amoeba. Encystment means there will be a cyst formation in amoeba if the conditions are unfavorable. So basically this is to surpass the unfavorable conditions. So during unfavorable condition, amoeba will be covered with a thick three-layered structure, so that it is not desiccated. Kya hongi unfavorable condition amoeba ke liye? Suppose there is a drying of ponds, there will be high temperature, or conditions are not favorable. So but when the conditions are favorable conditions return, so this will be forming small pseudopodiospores. Pseudopodiospores means, now these are small amoeba like organisms with a small amount of cytoplasm which encloses a small nucleus. So these pseudopodiospores will be moving out of this covering. This will be disintegrated and they can move around. Now let's see asexual reproduction in plants. Now in plants, the vegetative propagation is the method. Vegetative propagation means there will be some vegetative propagules that will be forming a new plant. What is a vegetative propagule? It is the part of a plant, vegetative part of the plant, that is able to form a new plant. Yaad karo, humne 11th mein padha tha. There could be roots, stem, or even leaves which are capable of forming a new plant. So, kya hoga? Suppose, let us see some examples. Roots se ek aise reproduction ho sakta hai. Suppose there are some roots left over of neem or ficus species. Neem, you need to know the scientific names, Azadirachta indica, फाइका स्पीशीज मीन्स मैं बात कर रही हूँ पीपल की, बरगद की या फिग ट्री की, अंजीर की, इन सभी पौधों में। इनमें अगर थोड़ा भी रूट पार्ट अगर रह जाता है मिट्टी के अंदर, सो दैट कैन इस हैज़ द केपेबिलिटी टू फॉर्म अ न्यू प्लांट। और स्टेम पे देखो, जैसे अंडरग्राउंड स्टेम की हमने बात की थी 11th में मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ प्लांट्स चैप्टर में, सो देर कुड बी ट्यूबर, पोटेटो ट्यूबर, देर कुड बी अ दिस राइजोम ऑफ अ जिंजर और टर्मरिक, एंड देर कुड बी बल्ब ऑफ अनियन और कॉर्म ऑफ अकेशिया, एलोकेशिया एंड कैलोकेशिया। सो दे हैव दिस केपेबिलिटी ऑफ फॉर्मिंग अ न्यू प्लांट एट सब एरियल, सब एरियल मीन्स जस्ट एट द सॉइल लेवल। देर कुड बी रनर, सकर एंड ऑफसेट्स, रनर एज इन ग्रासेस, सकर एज इन क्राइसेंथेमम एंड मिंट, एंड ऑफसेट जैसे इकॉर्निया में हो रहा था। सो दीज प्लांट्स विल बी एबल टू रिप्रोड्यूस वेरी फास्ट बाय नोड दैट मे अराइज फ्रॉम द लोएस्ट नोड ऑफ द प्लांट ऑफ द स्टेम, एंड दैट मे गिव राइज टू अ न्यू प्लांट। एंड समटाइम्स द एरियल स्टेम कैन बी कट एंड कैन बी यूज टू फॉर्म अ न्यू प्लांट, जैसे कि रोज में, ब्रायोफाइलम में, सिट्रस में, ऐसा हम कर सकते हैं। ओके, आई विल बी शोइंग यू व्हाट इज दिस दिस ऑफसेट लुक्स लाइक। अभी देखते हैं इसको, पहले इसको लीफ में देखें। लीफ से एक नया प्लांट बन जाता था ब्रायोफाइलम में, केलोन के और मैक्सिकन हेड प्लांट में, एंड बुलबिल्स मींस आर द फ्लेशी बर्ड्स, जैसे अगेव और पाइनएप्पल में। लेट्स सी सम एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम द बुक। सो एज योर बुक हैज सम डायग्राम्स, पोटेटो इज एन अंडरग्राउंड स्टेम, जिसको हमने कहा था ट्यूबर, पोटेटो ट्यूबर, एंड नाउ वी कॉल इट एज पोटेटो एज अ स्टेम, ऑल्दो इट इज अंडरग्राउंड बिकॉज इट हैज आईज, एंड फ्रॉम दीज आईज कैन अराइज सम एडवेंटिशियस बर्ड्स, सो दैट इज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड अ स्टेम। सिमिलरली द दिस राइजोम ऑफ जिंजर, अदरक में देखें, ये सब इसकी स्केली लीव्स हैं और दीज आर द नोड्स, एंड फ्रॉम द नोड्स कैन अराइज अ स्मॉल एडवेंटिशियस बर्ड एंड द रूट्स। सो दिस हाउ इट इज़ अ स्टेम, एंड दिस कैन, बिकॉज बेसिकली ये एक तरीका है प्लांट का टू सरपास द अनफेवरेबल कंडीशन, बट दे कैन रिप्रोड्यूस इन फेवरेबल कंडीशन फ्रॉम द सेम स्ट्रक्चर। सिमिलरली अगर ये देखें, दिस इज कॉल्ड द बुलबिल ऑफ अगेव। बुलबिल मीन्स दैट दिस इज अ फ्लेशी बर्ड दैट कैन गिव राइज टू अ न्यू प्लांट, एंड इन ब्रायोफाइलम और इन केलोनको there'll be these notches will be giving rise to the adventitious birds. So these notches, when they come in contact with the moist soil, they have this capability to form the adventitious birds. Now I was talking about the offsets. Offsets जैसे कि कॉर्निया में होता है और वाटर हाइसिंथ। Now this plant will be, this is an aquatic plant and it's a rosette plant. Rosette means there are condensed nodes and there'll be many leaves that will be arising from the condensed nodes. Now, because it's a floating plant, this will be forming a small runner, a condensed runner, on the surface of water, and will form a new plant. And this will keep on happening as the conditions are favorable. So, because the plant can multiply very fast, and this can cover the whole of water body very soon. So, this is called the crouch of water body, and it is also called the terror of Bengal. So, mind this, is an important thing for exam. Terror of Bengal. Terror of Bengal means this can cover the water bodies so fast, and it will drain the oxygen from the water, leading to death of many aquatic organisms. And because it multiplies very fast, so this has become an invasive weed in our ecosystems. So it has a phenomenal rate of spread. So we don't have any way out ki isko kaise India se ab bhagaya jaye, but this is now a nuisance for the aquatic ecosystems.